hands down.
Oh my nuts on. This
is a serious business. Let's see.
Dippy. God's on a beat. God's on a beat. God's on a beat. God's
on a beat.
Got
strong there, Bruce. Let's hear it from the legendary boys and girls. Oh, just a miss. Oh, that was close, Stephanie, but a miss. Oh, tell you what, here we go. Oh, very unfortunate. Look, only three misses. I'm not expecting Pete, so I'll presume. Might have just touched a peg, but not good enough for a strike. So no points on that end. No points on that end, but I'll tell you what, they're going to regroup. They'll settle their horses. And just maybe go for another bit of a strategy, I'm thinking, Stephanie Davis.
I think so, Richard. I've noticed that this team have very straight horses. I don't want to make any calls too early, but just watch, their horses are so experienced. They look like they're all lining up the 10.
One carry, two carries. Oh, and it may have been a strike. It's a possible 18 points right there.
Bruce is smiling as he approaches the peg. He picks it up, he examines. What's he gonna do?
Very deceiving, that smile, though, Steph Davis.
Ooh, he's talking to his wife, Diane, discussing with her.
I think he nodded.
Bruce, was there any nod? Bruce, let us in on your secret.
Close to his chest. Oh. The suspense continues.
You can do one thing, and that's show people how to now shear sheep, because people don't know that. They don't see that anymore. It's a dying art.
It is a dying art. And John, you're a farmer. How important is agricultural shows in showcasing local agriculture?
Oh, it's very important. It's the most important thing.
To support an agriculture show like this, such a case show is fantastic. You know, yourself, Ellie, put in, and Rowan, and everybody to make this happen today. And, you know, we get a big turnout to come and watch the shearing, and I'm just so wrapped. That's why I keep coming back to do it.
John, it's great to have you at the show. What are you most looking forward to seeing when you step away from shearing? What are you looking forward to seeing this year?
I'd love to go on holiday for a month. It would be good. It's funny, though, shearing is in our blood now. It's the same, you know, you will walk out to it. I still catch up with friends that I was sure with, you know, 30 years ago, and it's fantastic. You have that comradeship, you know, you just stick together, teamwork. You walk into a shearing shed at 5 o'clock in the morning, you see 2,000 sheep ahead of you, and it smells of urine. And
delicious, John. You're really selling shearing here.
We have the girls doing the rouseabouting, we have, you know, people walk past, we have the cook. So it's a team. If one person lets that team down, they're not very popular.
And you get
around the grounds at the final day of the Sunshine Coast Agriculture Show for 2023. We are in for some very fast and furious action indeed. We are going to bring you the race cars of yesteryear. Brought to you from the Vintage Speedway Association of Australia. You see the couple of rescue bikes come out, the four wheelers come out. You'll see the Speedway cars come out in just a few moments' time. They, of course, they don't have electric ignition like the ball. The officials will bring out the flags. I tell you what, some of the flags here are very, very important indeed. What happens if the yellow flag comes out, then that will indicate that there is an obstacle on the track. Usually a car has broken down or spun out on the track, hence the yellow flag will come out just as a safety measure. If the blue flag comes out, that will mean that one of the cars are passing one of the other cars, and that will indicate that the inside driver needs to move down on the track and allow the other car to pass. And of course, we all know what a checkered flag is all about. So that is just a couple of the signals that the drivers are given. I'm going to hand you over to Gail Robertson from the Australian Vintage Speedway Association. She's just going to tell us a little bit about more about what they're doing right now, the start of it, and it's a simulated race. I must stress that it's a simulated race. Gail Robertson, welcome to the Sunshine Coast Show 2023, the third one. Tell us all about how these cars operate, how they start, and what we're going to expect to see tonight.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Historic Speedway Association of Australia. Out in front, you've got cars in position at the moment. They'll be all push started. They do not have a starter motor and they do not have a clutch. So it's in gear and they're pushed away.
And you told me last night they get up to speeds of around 80 kilometres an hour. And it is fast, it is furious, it is a simulated race. So before we even start this simulated activity, we firstly want to make sure that everyone has got their limbs over the other side of the fence. Stephanie's good at sewing limbs back on, but I am not, and I don't want that job. So make sure you get them right back on the other side of the fence. If we do see limbs over on this side of the fence, we do have to stop this activity, so make sure you keep your arms up well back, ladies and gentlemen, the boys and girls. All right, Dale, what can we expect to see now?
Okay, first car away is Tony Eichenhoff. He has been the winner of the last two events, and it's a pretty high-powered vehicle, and it gets underway at high speed. He's usually around 80 k's around this track. Next car along is his arch enemy, Ben Maltz. They are, it's not racing, but they are competitive. Follow it up. There's Peter McCauley in number 50. Directly in front of him, a big pushed away now. It's Ivan Crawley in USA 1. They're all on the way now. Pick Devin Shear the way.
Just warming up, so they'll do a couple of rounds of warm-up. In the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, while they do the warm-up, this will get fast, let me tell you something. I'll just go a little more slowly around the track for a couple of laps, warm the cars up. This is the time, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this is the time when the race car drivers can hear you. This is the time to make some rocket noise. Let's hear it for them, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. One, two, three, go, let's hit. Got the yellow flag out already. Yellow flag.
Let's form them up.
Form them up.
Yeah, get them into their parade lap.
That's what that's all about. Okay, so get them into their parade lap.
We have those little kids off their fence over there, please.
We've got some kids on the fence over here. We do need, before we go into this race, ladies and gentlemen, just get the arms on the other side of the fence, please. We will have to put them. Thank you very much. Appreciate that. We do need to have all of the limbs on the other side of the fence. We don't expect anything to happen, but we just want to be on the air of caution for this particular simulated exercise. And of course, back to you, Dale. What can we expect to see?
Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. This is the salute, the crowd lap. Drivers will acknowledge people in the stand.
Hey, come on, ladies and gentlemen. Give them a huge round of applause. Give them a huge cheer. Make some noise for the Sunshine Coast. Now, away! 2020 was the clear winner. Let's see if we can do it again tonight. Tony Jim, blue card. He wants to win, doesn't he, this Tony?
He's definitely got an ego check out tonight. Hopefully there's more people in it.
Doing shows and then
we're picking them up from the top of the grandstand here, Stephanie Davies, all down on the ground. Single, over 18, on your feet and start dancing. got one more I think contender to my right, Steph. Score choice.
To my judges down here.
Do we have you made a pick? You're pointing up here, Gary Baxter. Do we need to do that again?
All right, I think I found a couple of girls, but we're looking for a couple more guys. Might have to play. Oh, here we go. We've got one guy down here in the front in the black jumper.
Oh, yeah, I see him. We've got two single girls. Two single girls. Where are they, Stephanie Davis?
There you go, Dan. Come
on, Dan.
We've got one in the white jacket up there.
Oh, there.
No, no.
Come on, Dan. We need one more couple.
One more boy. One more single man. One more single woman. Let's cue up the music and get the dancing happening again. Super use. I tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, this could be the start of something that could last a lifetime, but I'll tell you what, we really, really need it. Yourself. There you go, she places the helmet on,
tell you what, this is really something special. Thank you, Jim. Where's Jim and Chris? Secrets author Gary Baxter. I think that is what did their trick. And I think they were getting some romantic advice in the blue car, Stephanie Davies, but I would say it probably wasn't that good because they came in second place tonight. Gary Baxter's team, Bobby and Shania, take it home here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, I tell you what, this could be Stephanie Davies, this could be the start of something really special. Bobby and Shania, thank you so much for being such good sports. Of course, enjoy Sunshine and Sun's Gin Distillery, one of our major sponsors here at the Sunshine Coast Show. I'm going to present you with two vouchers and enjoy your very first date up at the bar. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for them. Janaya and Bobby taking home the vouchers tonight. So not a warm watch.
Congratulating all of you. Thank you so much for being a part of it. And we hope you have a wonderful night. Now, Graham and Gary, we're going to see you later.
Yeah, we've got one more show, last show of the night. And myself and Gary, we've got a few bets between us at the moment. He's up one, so I've got
let's hear it for them as they leave the track. I tell you what, we are going to see horsepower of a completely different type. Stephanie Davies, we've seen he's been on the education stage. He's been in the arena right throughout the last couple of nights. He's put on an amazing show here, ladies and gentlemen. Again, horsepower of a completely
different. It is not natural to see him as the first in the world to ever do this. That's why it's so important that you're clapping as loud as you are to show your appreciation to someone who works so hard at this. They have three teams across the world to do this. There's nowhere else I'd rather be than at your Sunshine Coast Show doing what he's made. Thank you so much. I'm the proud Australian Stock Horse Ambassador. I travel the world and there's nowhere I love more than our beautiful Australia, especially Queensland. Thanks so much. See you soon.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you what, that was the horseman from Susan River. I tell you what, that is just a little bit of what you're going to see. The action is going to get fast and furious right here at the Sunshine Coast Show. And I'll tell you what, ladies and gentlemen, just give you
I'm going to give you a rundown of what these gigantic ramps behind me are used for. This smaller ramp here is the up ramp. The boys are going to get onto this yellow runner. They are going to select second gear. They are going to pin it. They are then going to launch 75 feet through the air onto this portable down ramp. Now we want the guys to land in what we call in FMX the sweet spot. The sweet spot is located 2 meters from the top of that knuckle. If the boys do not land in the sweet spot, they are going to get badly injured. If the gentlemen on the motorcycles land in this playable airbag, I can guarantee you that inbox sock that will not tickle. On the other hand, if these guys go too big, too many berries on the gas, they're going to flatten out about 90 to 100 feet. They will probably break their legs and wrists. Luckily, these boys are trained athletes. That will not happen today. What you'll notice, there is no speedos on these machines, guys. They have to do runnings right now. They're testing the speed, testing the dune, making sure the right amount of wind's coming past their helmet. This is where muscle memory comes into play. Tyler has just given me the thumbs up, guys. That means the boys are warmed up and ready to send it. Are you ready to see them send it, Sonny Cash? You're waking up. I'm loving it. Here's Tyler for his first jump. Look how smooth he was, just waving to you guys. He's pumped up with the meter. This is Suzuki Navy. Show today, a warm up to put on the biggest show to date. I reckon Tyler's going to give you an old school here. Oh! He's back in his mugger. That's how far he was. He has to lock his foot under his brake. Luke Davey. Captain Morgan! That's my favourite trick. He just puts the foot up on the bars, hands on the hips. He thinks he's Elvis Presley, this bloke. You're a show off, Davey. Okay. Tyler the whip, big wave, but what's he got? Oh! That's a scorpion heart attack. He's only meant to be doing sea crabs and naughty panda. Rightio, Mr. Davey. What do you got, buddy? Bubble can, look back. Fully separated from that machine, folks. These boys are ripping it up out here today. You got to get loud, though, Sonny, in case you know. From the great Jeremy McGrath, just a big knack-knack with a big whip. That is a timeless trick, that one. Fully outstretched, massive heart attack. These boys are not holding back. This is our last show this weekend, guys, so the boys are not going to leave anything in the tank. Sunshine, guys, I present to you Tyler Wakeford and Lukey Davies. Righto, guys, who here has seen a backflip in real life on a dirt bike? Not too many. Who here wants to see a backflip? Right, you gotta bit the bird. Well, I'm gonna ask you a question first off, just to get this out of the way. Can you flip one of these things and get upside down over that enormous 75 foot gap?
Corey, it depends how loud this crowd gets. They want to see a backflip, they're gonna get loud.
Guys, did you want to see one or not? Sunshine Coast, do you want to see a backflip? Get him up and get him out, boys! Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the backflip. This is still the most dangerous. And the boys are still scared every time they do it. It takes so much skill and fortitude to pull this off. So, Sonny Coast, Tyler Wakeford, Edmund Davies! You have got to be kidding me. Just doubled enough, smooth as a baby's backside. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the Aussie MMS boys! We can do shows all around Australia, bruh. All the kids come and ask you, Tyler, me. Can I catch you guys here under that helmet? Can you hear the crowd?
Yeah, we sure can, and there is nothing that pumps us up more than when they are screaming their guts out. So the more you guys scream, the bigger we're going to send it.
You heard it, guys.
So start them up, boys. Head them out, and I'll let them know exactly what this is.
Okay, guys, you see that? They rock and roll. What they done before, that's old school stuff. This is the big hitting stuff, guys. guys, they're dangerous stuff. So I want you to get electrocuted. Oh, it was flying in my Superman. You have got to be kidding me. Luke Davies. On the machine. I did not believe this. Luke David. Bro! He's all the flies now. He looks like Jesus Christ up on the cross, tippy toes under the handlebars, only barely hanging onto that machine. Absolutely freaks of nature. Dollar Wakeford, jump number three. Oh, double grab handstand off the back of the machine. Absolutely crazy. I did not believe this. The boys are not leaving anything in the tank, folks. I hope you're loving this, because even I'm getting pumped up. Sunshine Coast, the boys! So, Tyler, mate, David just threw it out there. It was, I think he actually had you covered in tricks. Do you think you could one-up him?
Oh, yeah, I reckon we can have a bit of a game of one-up. Yeah, I reckon I could give my best shot, maybe take it out.
Alright, so guys, what we do, we have a little thing in FMX called One Up. So, these boys are competitive, always trash talking each other. I'm going to send them both out. One of them has to jump, and then the guy behind him, he has to pull a bigger trick than what the guy in front done. And now you have to tell me when they're finished, who has the gnarliest, craziest trick. So, just remember, Tyler is on the orange KDM. Luke Davies is on the white Yamaha. So start them up, head them out, boys, and let's see what you got here. FYI, folks, I have no idea what they'll do in this because they're very sneaky. They want to outdo each other. So let's just see what they've got. But remember, they can hear you under their helmet. So when he's coming in for this jump, I want you to get loud, Sunshine Coast. Here we go. Mr. Wakeford, what is he going to do to one up Mr. Davies here? I'm nervous. Whenever these boys get competitive. Oh! You're kidding me. I don't know how you're going to beat that. He was flying through the air for like 2 seconds, like Superman, not even attached to his bike. Unbelievable. You're going to have to pull something out of the bag here, Davey. Oh! You reckon you can do that upside down? No way. Do you want to see Tyler Wakeford do what Luke just done but upside down? I can't believe it. He only practices these into the foam pit. You must have him G'd up, Sunshine Coast. When he gets on this mat, I want you to lose your mind. This is insane. Tyler Wakeford going for a piss of death flip. Oh! You are kidding me. I cannot believe what just happened. This is absolutely nuts. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't believe what I just seen. We're going to have to do what I said, though. You're going to have to tell me who the winner of this was. Now, Sunshine Coast. Did Luke Davey have the biggest trick tonight? You actually got a bit of love. That's an improvement, mate. We've got to get to see how this plays out. Sunshine Coast. Did Tyler Wakeford have the biggest trick tonight? Tyler has absolutely wiped the floor today. Took our best bit of earlier. He's just taken out one up. Now, Mr. Davies. If I were to say, you have to race Tyler, do you think you could beat him?
Yeah, well, I think I'd be pretty well there, but who knows, I might have to get dirty and take him out. If I have to.
Who wants to see these two have a race? I do. I'm actually really excited. And Tyler brags a lot, so I don't want to have to listen to him all the way home tonight bragging. So we're going to have a race. I'm going to get a little bit of crowd participation. Who wants to help me?
I can hear someone screaming there. Who was that? I reckon it was you, buddy. That's what happens. The loudest kid always gets to help it. So what you hold that there? What's your name, sorry?
William.
Mate. It's your lucky night, bro. What's going to happen? The boys are going to cut two laps around a little track we have here. What they're going to do, William, they're going to ride over to you as quickly as they can without killing you. They're going to stop, get off their bikes. They have to grab the flag, run over and stand on the winner's dais. So that's how we're going to have a winner tonight. Boys, turn the bikes around. Stop talking trash. We're going to start this race off right now.
Don't get older.
I really hope Davies wins this. Look at him, they've already started it. Because otherwise Tyler is not going to shut up all week. Okay, you guys have to count me down. We're going to go from three down to one. Sunshine Coast, ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Tyler has just cheated. Tyler wants the winning point off before we even go. These boys are Looney Tunes. Okay, folks, so if you have a mobile phone, I highly recommend you rip it out, turn it on its side, because you might be able to catch two machines in the air doing a 46 stunt at one point of the night, if these boys can nail it, and if you guys get crazy enough. So as soon as they get on this tarmac over here, I want you to lose your mind. Who's going to go first? Tyler's draw, the shorts draw. Look at how close they are! What? You have got to be kidding me. Who's got a photo there? I need to get my phone out. These boys are absolutely wild. Here we go. Guys, they want to hear some love. This is going to be our last jumps for the whole night. Whenever they go quiet like this and slow, I really do worry. Tyler Wakeford, These boys are free